In his life, Commodore Stephen Decatur was a man of great adventure and heroic triumph. When the U.S. was faced with a problem, Decatur accepted and fought until he was victorious. For instance, the events with the USS Philadelphia and the battle on the small Tripolitan gunboat both ended in a victory for Decatur and the U.S. Decatur used his skills of strength and courage that he had obtained to be a heroic figure in the defeat of the Barbary pirates. People showed great envy towards him throughout his life. Although Decatur's life was cut short in his final duel, where he lost his life by a jealous Commodore, James Bear. We still remember him to this day for his heroic stand he took against the Barbary pirates during the times of need. On January 5, 1779, in Sinopuxent, Maryland, Stephen Decatur was born into the family of a naval officer. He grew up in Philadelphia and studied both at the Episcopal Academy and the University of Pennsylvania. Later, Decatur followed in his father's footsteps and became a naval officer.
During Decatur's years as a naval officer, the Barbary pirates roamed the seas. These pirates used to attack ships if they passed through the North African coast. To prevent them from seizing American ships, the United States paid a yearly tribute towards the Barbary pirates. However, in 1801, the pirates of Tripoli wanted more from the United States. When the United States refused to pay more to the pirates, they declared war on the United States.
To start off with the wars with the Barbary pirates, William Bainbridge, a commodore in the U.S. Navy in the 19th century, surrendered the USS Philadelphia after being attacked in the uncharted seas on the coast of the Barbary States. Then, when Stephen Decatur was at the young age of 25, him and his men finally decided to take a stand against the Tripolitan merchants that had taken our ship. Decatur came up with a magnificent plan that was put into action the night of February 16, 1804. Him and the other volunteers sailed into the Tripolitan Harbor on the USS Intrepid. They snuck aboard the USS Philadelphia dressed undercover as one of the Tripolitan merchants and went below the deck of the USS Philadelphia. The crew added gunpowder, bombs, and anything else they could burn into a pile that they would light on fire to burn the ship. Decatur used cannons on the USS and pointed them all into the middle of the ship, towards the pile. Him and his men lit the cannons, then jumped back onto the USS Intrepid and rowed as fast as they could away from the fiery explosion that set the USS Philadelphia on fire. With that, the ship was destroyed and Decatur had come out with his first victory in the Barbary Wars. In under 10 minutes, him and his men had accomplished the seemingly impossible task. From that point forward, Decatur took courageous and heroic stands in our history. Years passed, and Stephen Decatur received more recognition than ever before as he continued to patrol the seas. In these years, Decatur obtained many different naval positions, including a member of the Board of Commissioners and the commander of both the Enterprises and the Southeastern Navy Forces. On the water, Decatur continued to capture and imprison many of the Barbary pirate ships and squadrons. On one occasion, a gunboat led by Stephen Decatur's brother, James Decatur, had captured a small Tripolitan gunboat. The boat had surrendered, so the crew boarded the ship. However, while the crew boarded, the enemies raised their flag back up and proceeded to kill the officers of the unsuspecting naval ship. Stephen Decatur heard the news and immediately set out with a crew of 9 volunteers. Him and his crew boarded the small gunboat without hesitation, and Decatur made his way right to the captain that had ended his brother's life. Decatur battled out the captain along with the rest of the crew. Although they had been outnumbered, they ended the tough battle with only 3 pirates left alive. the victory in this battle and the new confidence from the victory over Britain in the War of 1812, the United States declared war on the Algiers, a major group of the Barbary Pirates. The new and powerful navy led by Commodore Decatur sailed out to the Mediterranean. The force had already overturned two warships and captured hundreds of prisoners by the time of Day Omar, the ruler of the Algiers, accepted the peace treaty Decatur had proposed. The treaty stated that all Algerian and U.S. prisoners would be exchanged along with the end of the Barbary Pirates' practice of tribute and ransom. Decatur then went and negotiated similar peace treaties with Tunis and Tripoli, the other contributors in the Barbary States. Finally, Decatur returned from the seas having defeated the Barbary Pirates and having stopped the harassment of American sailors. Accomplishing these events allowed Decatur to take an unforgettable stand in history. From the point that Stephen Decatur first defeated the Barbary Pirates until his death, he was known as a wonderful man, a true gift to America, and a national hero. Stephen Decatur's life came to a sudden end on March 22, 1820. James Barron had challenged Decatur to a duel due to Decatur having a part in Barron's 5-year suspension from the Navy in 1808. Decatur was shot and killed in a duel, but his wife, Susan Decatur, was right there for him as his wounds slowly brought him to death. He was buried by the side of his parents on Society Hill in Philadelphia. Stephen Decatur took an unforgettable stand in history after leading the U.S. to the defeat of the Barbary Pirates in the 19th century. Some people remember him by the words he said in April 1816 after returning from the seas. He toasted, "Our country, in her intercourse with foreign nations, may she always be in the right, but our country, right or wrong." Stephen Decatur is also well known by the multiple schools, buildings, and ships that were built in his name. Stephen Decatur was a great hero, and he will always be remembered for defeating the Barbary Pirates, stopping harassment of American sailors, and taking a stand in history.
Jefferson, the president during the times of conflict, stated, "So as best to protect our commerce and chastise their insolence, by sinking, burning, or destroying their ships and vessels wherever you shall find them," and started sending navy out to the sea. The force had already overturned two warships and captured hundreds of prisoners by the time Day Omar, the ruler of the Algiers, debated the peace treaty Decatur had proposed. When they had asked for time to think about the decision, Stephen Decatur replied, "Not a minute." Reluctantly, the Algiers accepted the treaty that stated all Algerian and U.S. prisoners would be exchanged along with the end of the Barbary Pirates' practice of tribute and ransom.